Hi everyone, this is Sainath. Today let us see part 5 of Constitution of India, that is Union Government. The Union Government consists of Executive, Parliament, Legislative Power of the President, Union Judiciary, Comptroller and Auditor General of India. The Executive consists of President, Vice President, Prime Minister, Council of Ministers, Attorney General of India. Now let us look at the President. The president is the head of the state, that is Indian state. He is the first citizen of India. He acts as a symbol of unity, integrity and solidarity of nation. Eligibility for the president. He should be a citizen of India. He should be of 35 years of age or above. He should be qualified to become a member of Lok Sabha. And he should not hold the office of profit. Election of President of India. The president is indirectly elected by the people of India, that is through Electoral College of India, consisting of elected members of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, elected members of state legislative assemblies, the elected members of Legislative Assembly of Union Territory of Delhi and Puducherry. The nomination of a candidate for the election to the office of president must be subscribed by at least 50 electors as a proposers and 50 as a seconders. Each candidate has to deposit 15,000 in Reserve Bank of India. The election is held in accordance with the system of proportional representation by means of single transferable vote. The voting takes place by a secret ballot system. The manner of election of the president is present in Article 55 of the Constitution. Now let us see the value of an MLA vote equal to total population of the state by total number of elected members into 1000. Value of an MP vote equal to the sum of vote value of elected members of all legislative assemblies by sum of elected members of both houses of parliament. Now let us look at electoral quota, that is total number of valid votes polled by 2 plus 1. Now oath or affirmation. To faithfully execute the office of president, to preserve, protect and defend the constitution and law, to devote himself to the service and well-being of the people of Republic of India. Now let us look at the powers and functions of the president, that is executive power, legislative power, financial power, judicial power, diplomatic power, military power and emergency power. Now let us look at these powers in detail. Executive powers. All contracts and assurance of the properties are made by the government of India in the name of president. The president appoints the important members of union government, that is prime minister and council of ministers on the advice of prime minister, chief justice of India and other judges of supreme court on the advice of the chief justice of India, chief justice of high court after consulting with the Chief Justice of India and other judges of High Court on advice of the Chief Justice of High Court, Chairman of UPSC and members of UPSC, Attorney General of India, Comptroller and Auditor General of India, Chief Election Commission and other members of Chief Election Commission. He also appoints the governors for the state, and he also appoints ambassadors and high commissioners, finance commissioner members, national commission for SC, ST and their members. And he also appoints administrator for union territories. Now let us look at legislative powers. The parliament is composed of president, Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha. So president of India is an inseparable part of the parliament. President has power to summon, prorogue the two houses of the parliament. After a prorogation, the house must be summoned within 6 months. The president may dissolve the Lok Sabha, but he cannot dissolve the Rajya Sabha because it is a continuous house. He may address the either houses or even joint sitting. The president may nominate two members of Anglo-Indian community in Lok Sabha, and the president has power to nominate 12 members of Rajya Sabha in the field of art, literature, science, social science, culture, etc. A bill passed by the parliament becomes an act only if it is given assent by the president. There are some bills which require prior recommendation of the president. This means these bills needed to be introduced in the parliament only on the recommendation of the president. These bills are the bills which seeks the alter the boundaries of the state and names of the state, and money bills and finance bills, any bills which affect the taxation in which the state or state interested, state bills which impose restrictions upon the freedom of trade. Now let us see the financial powers. A money bill can be introduced in the parliament only with the president's recommendation. The president lays the annual financial statement, that is union budget, before the parliament. The president can take advance out of the contingency fund of India to meet unforeseen expenses. The president constitute a finance commission after every 5 years to recommend the distribution of taxes between center and state. Now let us see judicial powers of the president. The president appoints the chief justice of union judiciary and other judges on the advice of chief justice of India. He dismisses the judges if and only if the two houses of the parliament passes the resolution to that effect. Here the majority is 2/3. According to Article 143 of Indian Constitution, if the president consider a question of law or matter of public importance has arisen, he can take the advice of Supreme Court. Diplomatic power. All international treaties and agreements are negotiated and concluded on the behalf of president. The president represents the Indian in international forum and affairs. The president may also send and receive diplomats from other countries. The president is the first citizen of our country. Military powers. The president is commander-in-chief of the defense force of India. The president can declare war or conclude peace, subjected to the approval of the parliament. All important treaties and contracts are made in the name of president. He also appoints the chiefs of the several chiefs of service branches of armed forces, that is army, navy and air force. Now let us see the pardoning powers of president. It is mentioned in the Article 72 of the Constitution of India. The power to grant pardon is in the following situation. Punishment is for an offense against the union law. Punishment is by military court. Sentence is death sentence. The decision involving pardoning and other rights by the president are independent of the opinion of Prime Minister or Lok Sabha majority. In most cases, however, the president seeks the advice of Prime Minister and Cabinet. Emergency power. The president can declare three types of emergency: national emergency, state emergency, and financial emergency. Under the Article 352, 356 and 360, in addition to the promulgating the ordinance under article. Ordinance making power of the president. The president gets the power only when the parliament is not functioning. The president has power to pass ordinance on the matters of which the parliament has power. The councils of ministers should suggest the passing of an ordinance on such matter. The president himself should be satisfied about the need for the ordinance and he cannot be compelled. Once an ordinance is passed, it should be placed before both the houses of the parliament and approved by them within 6 weeks of their respective dates of reassembly. The ordinance lapses if it is not approved within the said period, that is 6 weeks, or if it is rejected earlier, or if the president himself withdraws the ordinance. Now let us see the salary and residence of President of India. The salary and allowances of president are fixed by the Parliament of India. The current salary of the president is 1,50,000 per month. His official residence is at Rashtrapati Bhavan in New Delhi. Now let us see impeachment. The President of India can be impeached by the Parliament before the expiry of term for violation of constitution. Other than impeachment, no other penalty can be given to the president for the violation of constitution. No Indian president has faced impeachment till now. Hence, the provisions for impeachment have never been tested. Thank you. Thank you for watching. There will be a much more videos on polity series. Thank you.